veteran, Vietnam veteran.
Yes, wow. I have a question for you.
Yeah, where did you serve, by the way?
I served in the Army in 1966, 1967.
66 to 67. I was, I would have been a...
some college kid.
Yeah, I was just getting out of college. I graduated from high school in 65. And then I went to college for a year, and then off served my church for a couple of years. We're the same age.
Yes, we are.
We're the same age.
My question.
Appreciate your service. Yes, sir.
New Hampshire right now has some legislation kicking around about the appeal for the same-sex marriage.
Yes.
And all I need is a yes or a no.
Okay.
Do you support?
I support the repealing. I support the repeal of the New Hampshire law. I believe marriage is between a man and a woman. That's my view.
Okay, that means that if you're in the White House, you will not support any form of legislation that would change that so that servicemen would be entitled to benefits like a man and a woman. If two men get married, apparently a veteran spouse would not be entitled to any burial benefits or medical benefits or anything that the serviceman has devoted his time and effort to his country. And you just don't support equality in terms of same-sex marriage.
I believe that marriage is a relationship between a man and a woman.
Meaning?
And the Defense of Marriage Act that exists in Washington today defines... benefits for whether for veterans or for non-veterans as between married spouses, and for me that's a man and a woman, and we apparently disagree
on
that.
It's good to know how you feel that
that's
you do
right.
not believe that everyone is entitled to their constitutional rights.
No, actually, I think at the time the Constitution was written, it was pretty clear that marriage is between a man and a woman, and I don't believe the Supreme Court has changed that.
Governor, we got to get on with Fox News right now.
Okay. Oh, I guess the question was too hot.
No, I gave you the
y'all
answer.
Y'all have a good day.
You said you had a yes or no answer. I gave you the yes.
You did, and I appreciate your answer.
Thank
and you know, I also learned something, and New Hampshire is right. You have to look a man in the eye to get a good answer. And you know what, Governor? Good luck.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Have a good day to you,
You're
sir.
You're going
to
need it.
Thank you. You are right about that. Thanks. Good to meet you. Thanks, guys. Good
have
to see you.
Day.
Thank you. You too.
Right
here.
Okay.
Yeah. So, Bob, what did you think of his answer, Bob?
He's not getting my vote.
What is
Can you elaborate
he just,
a little
he, bit? He told me that I'm not entitled to constitutional rights. I think a man and a woman and a man and a man should be treated equal. What the hell's the difference?
So you were undecided coming in today.
Well, I was undecided. I'm totally convinced today that it's not going to be my president, at least in my book. At least Obama will entertain the idea. This man is... No way, Jose. Well, take your no way, Jose, back to Massachusetts.
Why do you feel so strongly about this?
Because I'm gay. All right? And I happen to love a man just like you probably love your wife. All right? And I think that he or she or whatever are entitled to the same rights that I have. I went and I fought for my country. I did my thing. And I think that my spouse should be entitled to the same entitlements that if I was married to a woman. What the hell is the difference?
As you were talking to the governor here, were you offended by his answer?
Absolutely. I was definitely offended. He doesn't even open the door to a conversation. It's just a boom. But I did ask him yes or no. So, I got what I asked for.
Are you a